Hello everyone, and welcome back to my kitchen. So today I've got something super exciting to share with you. I've come up with a carnivore pie crust using my brown butter milk solids. Super delicious, so quick, you're not gonna believe how tasty this is. But wait, what are brown butter milk solids, you ask? These are the little crispy, delicious golden bits left at the bottom of the pan when you brown butter. And earlier this spring, I discovered a way to increase the yield of these milk solids. But why do we want to increase the yield of these milk solids, you ask? Well, that would be to make some of the recipes that I have come up with using brown butter milk solids. There's a very easy way to create a larger amount of these solids. When you go to brown your butter, you'll add a little bit of non-fat milk powder. I will link the video on how to make those at the end of this video. There's no sound or anything. It's about a 45-minute process, and I just videotaped the whole process so you could see the melting of the butter, the adding of the powder, and then just how it slowly melts and forms, and I just stir it every once in a while. So it's really interesting, not super fun to watch, but at least you'll have that here. To watch after we create the crust here, or make the crust here. And I'll also share the link to that on my Instagram page as well. So I use this brown butter ghee. I've made brown butter ghee before, but this one just tastes really amazing, and the smell and the scent of it is just great. So this is my favorite one to go to, especially if I'm gonna be making sweeter recipes, sweet. So you can use regular butter if you want. You just want to make sure that it's melted. And I've used here, I went ahead and quartered this recipe because it's just me, and I'm going to be making some individual little cheesecake for a get-together that I'm having. So I didn't need to make the whole recipe. But so I've used about, like I said, 30 grams of brown butter ghee here, about 65 grams of the brown butter milk solids. And I did add a couple shakes of cinnamon to my brown butter ghee as well. So you toss it in, just like that, super simple. And then stir them around till they are all coated with the butter. And then, just like that, you literally just spoon them in individually. Or you can use a huge pie tin as well. If you use a springform pan, make sure to use parchment paper so that the butter doesn't ooze out of the bottom. So you can make these as thin or as thick as you like. And just for demonstration purposes here, I'm just gonna put a little bit in. And sometimes they're not so even, so I just grab, this is the only thing that I have, like a flat bottom, and so then I just kind of press it in there a little bit. And I'll show you here. There, just do a little bit. Press it in so that it gets a little bit flat and shaped. So this is what it looks like when it's pressed. And now they're all ready for filling and baking.